1848 hours of 311, 24, 73 degrees in here. Here's the current going into this thing. 1 milliamp. There's 20 milliamp scale. 1 milliamp, 1.3s. This is at 287 volts. Bulb is off. Input is 14 volts at 50 milliamps. Kick it up. Here's 405 volts. That's scooting pretty good. There's my 8 nano cap. So 1.8, 2 milliamps, that's on a 20 milliamp scale, amps. Or 10 volts. There's a lot of high voltage flying through there. I think some of it's backing in either from this. Well, it's got to be coming from that. So 2 milliamps. That's the 10 amp scale over here. This is the milliamp. Input is 24 volts at 80 mil. There's that FM. That was a flat line. 83,090s, 112 kV, 114 kV. That's peak. It's still going over. It shouldn't be arcing. It just keeps going up and up. Seems 145 kV. That's a good old transformer. That's a lot better than that last one. This one's efficient. We can fix, I don't know what the, thing jumping back and forth. I can hear the difference in that. It's got that whisker brush on there. That's minus. Minus current? Now what does that mean? That's the, oh, that's a 20 milliamp scale. There's a 2 milliamp. Oh, there's a 2 milliamp scale. At 408 volts. It'll go higher than that. 440 volt cap, 60 microfarad. Well, it don't seem to be backing up much. That's to take the top off any high voltage. According to Newman, Mr. Newman, says use this in place of the ground strap, or the grounding. It gives more push back into the coils, which it does. Seven, 2 milliamps. Point 0.6 screens. So there it is. That's the current measurement. 411 volts in, running, 411 volts into that, 23 volts, 80 milliamps into this. That's pretty good conversion. We're getting 411 volts, 2 mils out. How about that? Now how long is it going to run? That's about 30 seconds. Okay, a little more than that. So there we go. 311. Minor repairs. 440 volts it's running at. Keep an eye on that cap. Now this thing. This 54 cycles, this is, that's just a frequency of that transformer. Anyway, I'll leave that off. Got an AC RMS2 and a DC, so I'm getting 1,000, 1,400 volts DC running through there. Guessing that's how that goes. This minus 20,000, So this would be all negative current. Got the probe attached to one side of the coils. Now this thing's stuck at -3, -3000, high 3, -8, -2, minus. Now this is what's concerning me. You'll get these big jumps, which I don't know if it's coming off the points or I'm getting arcing inside the coils like that. It's a 25k load. FM. Peaks 60s, 70,000 volts, 60s, 70s, goes higher than that. 80s. Now he was talking about, there's 102,000. He was talking about 100,000 volts. If you did something. Just got the whisker brush on the end. Thousand, 114,000 volts, 128,000. It's staying in the negative up here, the mean, most of the time, 16, 35. There's a 25 megahertz. That thing's unchanged. Huh. Wasn't like that before. Okay, so what's changed on this thing? Other than that big 8 nano. Still 80 nano. I know we're around 440 volts. 442. Yeah, 442. 25 volts in. Yeah, that case is at 440 volts. Gotta watch that sucker. Bulb isn't even on. Okay, so what is all of this?